How did this investment become a real product for Amazon?
It was a collaborative effort between Amazon and Hippo Harvest over the last 15 months. When we first diligenced and sourced the deal, we saw two really compelling features about the opportunity. One was to drive down the price, and the second was to increase the quality of the investment.
Right.
And so we've worked for 15 months now, hand in hand, to bring this product into market in our fresh stores, iterating on the timing, the packaging, the quality of the produce, the price point, and we're finally able to get it over the line and proud to announce it here today.
Well, let's talk about the economics of it then. My understanding is they have a pretty small footprint down near Santa Clara or Santa Cruz. Is this a money maker? Is this a viable business long-term for Amazon to make these investments and convert them to product?
Absolutely. From the Amazon Climate Pledge Fund point of view, we have a dual mandate of both reducing carbon emissions for Amazon and also looking to do it profitably. So for us, Hippo Harvest really represents the best of both of those cases. And I think they're already demonstrating that down there in Pescadero. And the hope is that that scales throughout the network and around the world here in the years ahead.
Can you give us a sense on timing of scaling? When might I get it in New York? When can you get it abroad?
It's going to take time, Caroline. We're in a crawl, walk, run experimentation phase. The first step is just to get it into the market and validate customers are interested in purchasing it. Our expectation is we will scale that throughout the Amazon and Whole Foods ecosystem. And then we're going to look to support Hippo Harvest as they try and expand both domestically and internationally. But we would expect that's going to take a couple of years before we finally hit that stride.
We've been looking at some of the pictures of how this all works. I can see your robots that are there. And I know you're a man who talks about startups, about climate, but you also talk about workforce. How is this sort of focus, this efficiency, going to be impacting blue-collar workers and an ability to need that sort of labor?
Well, we're just beginning to learn how these robots are going to change the dynamics on the farm. I think one thing we've seen early on is that Hippo Harvest is still employing local employees and bringing their farm expertise to bear to help produce this produce. And then we're also seeing new jobs emerge, obviously servicing and supporting the robots, but also doing quality assurance and control and supply chain management to modernize these farms. And so my suspicion is the net of it's going to be we see job growth in both areas as we look to secure our food supply chain there.
Nick, I know you're an Amazon Climate Pledge Fund principal. That's your job. My question, can Hippo move as fast as it's done without Amazon behind it? Does it take an Amazon to bring this kind of rapid success?
Certainly having Amazon behind you is a key catalyst. I think one of the things we've looked for in our investments, though, are proven entrepreneurs that can reliably deliver innovations to market. Certainly with Hippo Harvest, we have serial entrepreneurs here, and they've done it again. So our expectation is we'll see more of the same, and it doesn't necessarily require Amazon.
Very, very quickly, have you eaten the lettuce? Is it good?
I have. It's fantastic. Highly recommend everybody give it a try.